out at Donnie Krebs right now picking up our seatbelts, and he does steering wheels, or steering shafts, I should say, Camaro, Chevelle, a lot of good stuff. Boy, he's got parts everywhere. Look at all the stuff he's working on right here. Amazing. It's kind of hard to get a good shot in here because there's a lot of sunlight coming in, but very cool. Look at all the stuff. You know it's good when you got a lot of good stuff like this. Here's the seatbelts all restored up, and I'll show you some pictures of these things before we send them out here. All right, some details that keep falling through the cracks working on the 70 Chevelle. There it is over there. See it? Okay, here's all the seatbelts from it. We're going to send it out to a guy that Denver is friends with. I can't remember his name, but he's in Ohio. And we're going to send the whole set out to him for restoration. So these are the actual seatbelts that came out of the car. And as you can see, they are, yeah, so-so looking. Got a little rust here and there and whatnot. They look nice, let me tell you. Woo, look brand new. And we've got the correct labels on it and everything. Love it. Hey, Mark Meldrum, Meldrum's Monster Garage, working on the 1970 SS Chevelle. And we're coming down the home stretch on getting the seatbelts installed. So as you can see over here, I've got a seatbelt installed, and it's got a cover around it here. Okay. Some of your best friends when you're doing this job, pair of scissors, really good pair of scissors. We got these at Harbor Freight, and they've been doing a great job for cutting carpet. I've got a nice sharp knife. And then for cutting out holes like this, it's actually pretty easy to use a soldering iron. So you get your soldering iron and you kind of roll that around like that. So I'm gonna get the seat in, and then we are going to bolt that down, and then I'll get this last seatbelt in. Got the back seat all taken care of. Seatbelts are all in there. I've got these little flaps cut. Okay, so you got a nut on this one. Okay, that's the only one that gets a nut right there. Everything else gets a bolt. There's a bolt there. Got these little flaps cut. I think that's the way the factory did them. We'll see. I'm sure somebody will say something. And I don't know why they had this little area cut out, but they did. I was looking at some of pictures online and talking to some people. Daryl Davison has been a real joy to talk to and work with on this. I appreciate his input. And of course, I look at Rick Nelson's pictures. So yeah, we're coming right along on getting this together. So I'm gonna get these seatbelts up high so I can slide the rear seat in. And then we're gonna get the front buckets in. Okay, I'll see ya in a few minutes. I also wanted to make a little remark on something. You know, we took this car to the Northern Ohio Chevelle show, you know, partially built. And of course you get people looking at it and pointing things out. Something I did not realize that Jeff LaSapio pointed out was how this gets installed right here and what order. So you've got this rubber piece right here, and then you got the part of the interior right here. And I did not realize that behind this little flap here is part of the metal there for this piece of trim. And I had screwed in the piece of rubber, and I had the piece of metal on the inside. Well, this piece of metal goes on the outside, and then there's a little screw. And I couldn't quite figure out what he was talking about until I lifted it up and saw that there was a little hole there. So then I changed that around, put the hole through the screw there, and then it's nicely covered up by that little flap there, so you don't see the screw there. So, hey, thanks, Jeff, for pointing that out. And like I say, always trying to improve my restoration techniques here, and appreciate that comment. Well, I got over to the other shop where this seat was sitting just in time. So it's pouring out there now. I pulled that over. So the Chevelle gods are with me today. I got that over before I got drenched walking between the two garages. But just a comment here before I put this seed in. And I left a build sheet, and I left a copy of the window sticker under here for somebody to find 50 years from now. But and this one's even signed by Richard Doyle, who worked on the car a little bit at the Northern Ohio Chevelle show. But just a little comment. There's basically a hook on either side of this. So you're going to set the seat down on the hook. And then down below, there's a couple bolts that are going to hold this seat back in. Now, when I put this, the bottom in, what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of loop it in there under the seat. And you'll see what I'm talking about. I'll take a picture halfway through. And then these hooks right here are going to hook onto the wire that's in the seats. So this is kind of challenging because you got to get the seat belts out of the way. I thought about taping them up, but I think I can figure this out. So, and I'm in my socks now because I don't want to get my I don't want to get anything dirty on the carpet. So let's see what we can do here. All right, so you can see I've kind of finagled the seat in there and pulled the seat belts up. Kind of challenging by yourself, but this is still kind of setting up high, and I'm gonna push this in. And then hook it. All right, so I got the seat in there. I've got a little bit of a pucker down here. I think I can just glue that down and take care of that. But there we go. There's the back seat installed. Now let's work on the front seat. All right, so we got the seat in there. Had to make a few trim adjustments, but not too bad. Now we're going to put the seat belt in. Now these are Robbins seat belts. How do I know that? Well, they say Robbins on there, and I don't know if you can see that, but it says Robbins, and that's a 6715R. So I assume R means right hand. So we're going to put these in, and I'm assuming that they go this way because they're angled that way. So we've got a nice, big, hefty bolt. And we're going to put it down in there and tighten her up nice and tight and then snap the cover back on. Some interesting things about Chevelle seats. Sometimes you see a chrome piece through here, and on the Chevelles, you won't have that. It's just black. I'm not sure whether a chrome knob goes there or a black knob goes there, but maybe you guys can tell me that. It's all about learning. And then, of course, you do have the chrome strip that goes around the back of the seat with a little kind of bullet on the end there. I think that's right, too. All right, let's keep going. All right, so there you go. Got the seats in. Got them bolted down. I'll work on getting the rest of the seat belts in tomorrow as far as this side goes. And then we'll put the top plates on the center console, which I didn't talk about too much. So there you go. Oh, yeah, yeah. And I don't know if I mentioned this, but you might want to take the sill plate out before you put the seats in, just so you don't drop it on there and ding or dent that. All right. Mark Meldrum, Meldrum's Monster Garage. Have a Chevelle of a day. See ya.